biggest and best blockbusting movie action you've ever seen.
Bruce Willis is under siege in Die Hard.
Oh my God, the quarterback is toast.
Gonna need some more FBI guys, I guess.
They should have called Chuck Norris and the Delta Force, taking action in an explosive hostage scenario. And Nick Nolte is one of three fugitives in a hair-raising adventure.
Ludwig!
I spend all my time with murderers and rapists. And what's really crazy is I like them.
Sure, defending the suspect in a messy murder case. But Julie Walters solicits a different brief in personal services.
I thought Mr. Markles was for House of Pain.
No, Winky Poos and Bop Bops.
Michael Douglas has something similar in mind, but it becomes a fatal attraction. And in Wall Street, money is his main motivation.
Your parents are KGB agents. Sleepers, they're called. But when they awake, they're lethal.
Clint Eastwood handles a large and lethal weapon in the Deadpool.
And you know what that means.
But someone's got designs on his destiny. The biggest stars in the blockbusting movies you won't want to miss, only on TVS.
Where next tonight, news for and about Europeans in the Big E.
Morton 2, Hamilton 2, Berwick 2, Albion 2.
I want to be rich. I want to be very, very, very rich.
5-4, 4-5, 5.
Come on, just one more.
Cowdenbeath 2, Alloa 2.
Yes, yes, I want to be a millionaire. Right, where's the champagne?
Clyde 3, Brecon 3.
What?
Dumbarton 2, East Stirling 2.
I just want to be wealthy, then just ordinarily wealthy.
Stranraer 1, Queen's Park 1.
Oh, well, that's it then.
Stenhousemuir 1, Arbroath 7.
Well, lucky old Arbroath.
If you want to get richer slowly, but surely, you'll want a with-profit savings plan from Prudential. From the outback of Australia, you can see the lights in Paris. Or survey the hills of San Francisco from atop the Great Wall. From Mount Fuji, you can see the pyramids of Mexico. Through the eyes of a Buddha in Thailand, you can see the Thames rolling through London. And from the heartland of America, you can see the majesty of Rio. You can see it all on United, with renowned international service spanning Asia, the Pacific, Latin America, and Europe. From London's Heathrow, more than 200 cities in the USA and 31 countries beyond. Come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
Anyway, I was in the post office when she comes in, picking up a HGV license application. Not for him with an articulate lorry. And the Packamac and the sideboards. All I'll say is he was at the post office opening a joint national savings account Tuesday last.
Ooh, I thought there'd never be more than one slice in his toaster. Don't look. Him on the 73. He was in for a bus pass and a look at the electoral register. And I think we all know whose particulars he's been taking down.
He never is.
And then you, Nigel. He comes in the post office to get some photos enveloped. Fancy. Apparently he's got one of those paranoid cameras.
We saved £100 on the same holiday as our friends.
By booking at Lund Poly.
Ah, get away.
People are strange.
Today's food.
Michael Winner's True Crimes, tomorrow at 9:50 on TVS.
coming up on the E. Condoms and Catholics, where you can't slot it into, slip it on. Square Deal Surfers, we're on patrol with those beautiful bay watchers. We show you just how easy it is to cop off with a supermodel. In Too Deep, we get a little crazy with Sealing the Surfers. And we've some Benelux boogie from Candy Dulfer and Patrick Brule. In the depths of a Cork City club, the law is being broken. But drugs aren't being sold or stolen goods being bought. A simple, innocent condom machine is being installed in the gents' toilets.
Well, we're part of a group called Condom Sense, and we've been installing these machines. We've installed about 20 of these machines now around in this area and about another 30 in Dublin. And our reason for doing it really is in response to the government's inability to deal with the whole condom issue in Ireland.
Although condoms may at last be available freely in ultra-Catholic Ireland, a hiccup in the law means that vending machines are still illegal, and any attempt to change it is being vigorously fought by the church and its pressure groups.
They're opposed to sex education, they're opposed to the availability of condoms, they're opposed to information on sexuality in every way, and they are very vociferous, they're quite powerful in Irish.
Young people who support the banning of the machines see them as a threat to the morals of Irish youth.
If we're to put vending machines into public houses, what we're talking about is promoting sales, promoting the use of it. That's why vending machines are there. Sex becomes something for pleasure, it becomes something for a kick, it becomes demeaning to people involved. The sacredness of sex, the sacredness of people is going to be completely wiped out, and we're going to be left with the consequences. And I, as a taxpayer, will be paying for that.
I think condoms are the greatest insult to a woman. No, I would not use a condom. There's natural family planning. There are other ways, but I think condoms are an insult.
You're trying to sell this to the Irish people and saying, look, this is damage limitation. This will save you. This will mean that if you sleep around, you won't get these diseases. But that is not true.
Not unsurprisingly, those in favour of the machines, including the landlord of the first pub to install one, feel that the pressure groups are being unrealistic. They'll continue to put in new machines every time the police confiscate them.
Please take down the condom machine, giving me ridiculous statistics, the 16% again, a failure and all this, but the 84% success rate was never mentioned in any of those, As I believe it's about time, that we change our attitudes. I'm dealing with reality in here, I'm not dealing with a moral issue, the Catholic Church, anything like that. The reality of the matter is that, young people come in, they drink, they're going to have sex. They're going to have sex for pleasure, not just for reproduction, which is what the Catholic Church says you should do.
Caught in the middle of this church versus the rest debate are the youth of Ireland who, on the whole, back the machines.
At least in this pub at the moment, there is that choice. The sex is going to happen one way or another. Nobody's going to stop it. Least of all the Catholic Church.
But if you go into a chemist down the country now where everybody in the town knows each other, and there's a young kid, she's 16 or 17, or a young bloke, and he wants to go into the pub, or not a pub, but into a chemist, The chemist knows his parents, he knows everything. He gets all this vibe attitude, He's looking at the kid, he intimidates the kid, and a lot of the time will not give the kid the condoms anyway,
The attitudes are that it's bad, it's dirty, it causes diseases, it causes unwanted pregnancies. It's just an attitude, a bigoted attitude, I think, personally, from the church.
The church and family organisations have now realised that claims of Ireland becoming a moral cesspit don't work. They're now moving on to the safety of the offending pieces of rubber.
My feelings are that people are being sold a false sense of security because condoms do not work. There's a failure rate of about 1/6. That's in teenagers, and if people are using it for the first time or under the influence of drink, as happens in pubs, they will have a higher failure rate, even up to 60%. So really, we're not talking about the last line of defence against AIDS. We're talking about putting people in mortal danger.
But the widespread availability of contraceptives has brought a lot of ills on society. It's brought venereal disease at an alarming rate all over the world. And it's also brought broken marriages. Lack of morality has resulted in broken marriages. It's resulted in abortion and all the consequences of abortion and all the trauma that happens to the woman. And of course, not to mention all the killed children. But So this is not an answer to society.
As the machines go up and the law continues to be broken, the two sides of this condom conundrum remain entrenched.
Otherwise, we'll just go down the same road as America and England. Increase of AIDS, increase of teenage pregnancies, increase of abortions. We'll go down the same slippery slope. And those countries are now realising, 20 years' time down the road, America, that they've gone the wrong way. They're realising now what it has done. It has done no good for anybody. More deaths, more promiscuity. It's done nobody any better.
We really have to impose a certain amount of guidance onto young people. I mean, we're adults, we've been through the mill, we know right from wrong, we know the pros and cons. We have to protect our young people. We can't suddenly put vending machines in pubs and say, you know, go on, have sex, it's no problem, have sex with someone you're not committed to, have sex with anyone you want. It's wrong. Like, I mean, it's an attack on the family unit.
But it being against the law here, I mean, the law has to change.
I mean, as well, when Tampax machines came out, they weren't allowed in either. It took ages. There was a big long protest about them as well. It's ridiculous.
And what's the view of the people coming into this pub just to drink or to actually use the machine?
Well, we're sold out every night. Cork is a great place. We're sold out every night.
Danish researchers have announced that the sperm count has fallen 50% since 1940. Men most at risk are those with a driving or a desk job. Apparently, the lack of airflow and the warm climate down there is completely fatal for the testes.
Anyone for volleyball?
Rolling. Speed.
And action.
Rolling. Very quiet. No background.
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 Background. Okay, yes, Scott, is the background ready?
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Do you know where I can find the Baywatch location?
Yeah, just follow me. It's right up here.
Oh. How convenient, and we didn't know it. It was only behind us. Who are you and what are you doing here?
My name is Morris Reeves, and I'm guest starring in an episode of Baywatch at the moment.
So tell us, what's the plot of the episode we're watching being made now?
it's a foreign prince and his daughter, princess, that come in a yacht. There's a big motorboat race, and I'm his chief of security, and she wants to lead an ordinary life, you know, eat hot dogs instead of pheasants and stuff and lounge around on the
silly
beach.
Silly girl.
Yeah, silly girl. And she
throw away Ramex cards, yeah.
Yeah, there's some kind of plot about kidnapping her, and we're never quite sure whether she's going to get kidnapped or not. She disappears on her own and falls in love with Hasselhoff, you know.
Right.
Not me, unfortunately. I never get those kind of roles.
Lara.
Lara.
Hey. Only I can't pronounce it well, but it's Lara.
So are you the assistant director?
Yes, I am.
Right, and we don't want to talk to you then.
No.
Right.
No. Okay, I don't want to talk to you either.
So Lara, just while the camera's being turned around before they tell us off, is it you're just guesting on this episode, right?
Yes, I'm a guest star. I'm playing Princess Catherine Ranenberg.
Ranenberg?
Yeah, Ranenberg.
So you don't look like a California girl. Where are you from?
No, I have mixed blood. I have a Spanish, German, and a little bit of exotic blood that I'm hiding away.
Oh, I love that exotic blood. That's good.
The background's down.
Oh, look, we're getting told off.
Away.
Well, Lara.
Limey's out of here. Oh.
Good acting. Limey's off the set. What about the girl with the big, leg muscles?
Big leg muscles. I haven't seen her today. She may come.
Oh, right. Yeah, she must be heard off.
I hope she
down.
Does, because I like her leg muscles a lot. Quite all round, folks.
Excuse me.
What are you doing there with that thing right there?
I was stroking your back.
Oh.
We know you like those girls. Come on, admit it. Uh-huh, see?
It's the star of the show. Jeremy Jackson plays David Hasselhoff's son. Mr. Jackson, London Weekend Television here.
Okay.
We were admiring your acting skills there.
Thanks.
So what's it feel like having your own chair nowadays?
Oh, this is my chair. I didn't know they had it out today. It's pretty cool. It's fun.
When did you decide you want to be an actor?
I never really did. But about 5 years ago, I forget how old I was. I was not seven. I was always doing stuff for the neighbors and my mom's friends. Like, when my mom's friends would come over, I'd put in a record and I'd start singing and dancing to it. And I was never really shy. All right. So my mom just decided to give me an agent, and they liked me, so I started going out on auditions.
It's a pretty girl you're acting with today.
What?
It's a very pretty girl. Can you get her phone number for me?
Yeah, sure, I'll get him.
Just tell us.
The one that you were interviewing over there?
Yeah, I'm the sexy guy from England who needs to work out. That's what all the girls over there, the extras, said I've got to work out, because I'm a bit flabby. Okay, everybody bring your stuff. Hold on. Knobbly knees as well. Yeah. 1-2, 1-2.
Okay.
1-1-2. Right.
Thank you.
This is the real David Hasselhoff. Check this.
That's a rough job, and somebody's
going to
do it.
How are you? How are you? Hello, hello. How are you?
Hello, what's your name?
Rolling. Mikey, where'd he go? Pull him over here. Right here. Oh.
This is an on the run interview.
Guys, and we're ready.
Okay.
Let me get
you.
So, David?
Right. So, David.
You guys later we'll have lunch. And go. Yeah, go ahead.
David, yes. I'm only going to give you 2 minutes with me, okay?
Okay, what do you want?
Now, I'm so busy, and then we've got to go.
Okay, right. Go ahead. Right.
So, you're serious. Was this something that you always, you know, would you always want to do something about the beach or just, you know, was it a production?
No, what I wanted to do is I wanted to be a producer. It was more important to me to be an owner and have creative control is the most important thing, because then you don't have to fight. There's no stress. You don't have to stress out with 15 producers who are bosses. I know what my audience wants. It's an instinct. I know what they want: action, not violence. They want romance, not sex. They want to see beautiful people and beautiful beaches, and they want to be moved. It's not about murder and, you know, and sex and drugs and stuff that they're downers. It's about entertainment.
So listen, what's for the immediate future? Are you going to keep your character in the series? Do you think that's...
Oh, sure, sure. I cast myself. If I take my character out of the series, there will be no money, see?
Right.
For this series. So my character will definitely be in the shows. My music career is getting bigger and bigger.
Are we ready for a plug here, are we?
Well, no, there's no plug involved. It's just happening. I'm recording with Pete Waterman, and we're going worldwide with my music. I sold 4 million records in Germany. I did 40,000 people open air last weekend. And I was supposed to go to Prague this weekend for a concert, but my wife's having a baby this weekend, so I'm going to be in town. But no, I'm excited because Pete Waterman's got a little...
So we could see you doubling up with Kylie Minogue on a concert tour.
Kylie's a friend of mine. It's a good company. She sold 30 million records, and she's so little. That's a million records an inch.
Okay, well, you ready for the specialty?
Yeah.
Do the specialty.
1, 2, 3. See you, Mike.
That was worth waiting for. I'm going to have a sandwich. Bye.
Jim, quick!
She's blonde, beautiful, and blows a damn fine sax. Born and bred in Amsterdam, she's the girl who put the sax in sexuality.
I started playing saxophone when I was about 7 years old. My dad is a tenor sax player, Hans Dilfer, and we always had saxophones lying around the house, so I just tried one day and liked it. I started playing professionally when I was about, I think, sounds strange, but I think 11 or 12.
Oh. Candy's worked with just about everyone in the business. People, it seems, can't resist the famous Dulfer tonguing technique.
I did some stuff with Dave Stewart, with Prince, with Pink Floyd, some live gigs, and with Van Morrison. And for me, it's sort of an extra to the things I do. I have my own career, which I think is very important. But, you know, when those people ask you, it's just great to be, you know, part of their music. Dave is very intuitive about getting people to play on his records and stuff. So he just said, well, let her, you know, bring her over without ever having heard of me. And we had a great time. I played with, you know, the real band, the Eurythmics, and we made the whole soundtrack in about, I think, 4 days. It was really happening. And he was in Holland during his Love Sexy tour, and I think it was 87. And a few months later, he started calling me and asking me if I wanted to do some session work for him.
But Candy's own career isn't exactly quiet. Her last album, Sexuality, sold well all over the world.
About 1,000 people than for like 50,000. I mean, the acoustics are much better when you play in a smaller club. And it's just nicer, you know, you can see everybody in the audience, you can see their reactions, what they think of your playing, like, or this. And if you play in a big stadium, you just see these tiny sort of black spots, you don't know whether they're laughing or whatever. I really prefer clubs, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have agreed to come to this place, just around the corner from where Jack the Ripper killed most of his victims. This man is now draped to me in a red for blood towel and a piece of rather unpleasant plastic that he's tying rather tighter than he should. And he's about to start molesting me facially. Aren't you, Daniel?
Yes, I am. With pleasure.
Okay. Big, big, big.
Plain southern fries.
They're chips?
Yeah. Yeah. But what have McCain done to them?
They've given them a southern style coating.
Mm, it makes them really crispy.
They're spirals. And lattice too.
Great.
McCain have given real chips a light southern style coating for extra crispness and a great taste bite after bite. Crisp new McCain southern fries.
I love them.
Free with the people tomorrow, a great gardening and DIY extra, plus how to get your free packet of seeds, and in your glossy magazine, The Amazing Sex Revolution, why it's better to play at home than away. Plus, win Sega Game Gears and save on a family bargain break at Pontins. Reveals the soccer sensation of the season. Buy the people tomorrow.
There's 20% off all furniture except kitchens at Texas Now. Bedroom, dining room, living room furniture, pine furniture, all 20% off at Texas.
Big, big, big.
Who's our guest in the chair this week? It's Jonathan King.
That's wonderful.
How do you feel, yeah?
I feel fantastic. Yeah. Have you ever seen skin that perfect before, Daniel? Are you looking at it with envy and jealousy, thinking, I wish I had the complexion that this man had? Can you imagine? I looked like a 21-year-old. It was hard to imagine that I'm actually 27.
Right. Looking at your skin, I can see you got lots of redness, and it's something to do with your diet and the way you shave. You got bags under your eyes. I mean, your hair is fine, and just it's nothing happening really. I don't know who's. I mean, what have you been using on your hair? What have you been using on your skin?
Well, what I use on my hair is called soap and water. Well, shampoo to make sure it's always clean and smells nice.
Yeah.
And on my skin, I just use soap and water, and I have a lot of baths. And but I live a good life, Daniel. There's
you
no drugs, no drink. You know, I don't misbehave.
What are you going to do? Yeah, have you looked at it?
I mean, I think it's wonderful hair.
Ridiculous.
It's soft hair.
Whoever cut your hair for 16 years should get early retirement 10 years.
47
ago.
Years, I got news for you.
Oh, yeah, God, look at it.
Well, what do you want to do to my hair?
Well, I could make it look longer. I could make it look more sexy.
I don't want either of those things under any circumstances.
I mean, people will actually notice you after I've cut your hair.
That's the third thing
they
don't want.
They will realise you're a person. At the moment, you're walking and they can't see you.
Yes, a light trim would do fine, actually.
Yeah, so now I can do something really... Mm. Really good. So, if you're going to step over there, and I'm going to wash your hair.
Mm.
I was kidnapped in America by a woman.
Oh, were you indeed?
Yeah.
Sounds rather ominous. She wasn't a Mormon, was she?
No.
They always tend to be Mormons, these kidnappers. Why did she want you, may I ask?
She had my body. I mean, she said, your accent, she said, keep talking.
But your accent and your body are two separate things, Dan. Or are they linked?
She wanted both.
Did she want them at the same time?
Yeah, she wanted me to talk.
And the razor at the same time.
And the razor. And
sounds dangerously kinky to me. I only hope this part of the show is airing after midnight.
She asked me, she says she will only have a date with me, only in one condition. When we go back to her apartment, I blow dry her hair. I get in a shower with her, I blow dry her hair, and then we make love, and then she will open a couple of bottles of champagne. She kept me for 4 days there.
Oh, 4 days.
Yeah, it's just an amazing experience.
It lends an entire new meaning to the words blowjob.
Okay, if you want to take a seat there, your life's going to change
that.
Now.
Security is at an all-time high.
But we're never gonna survive unless we get a little crazy. No, we're never gonna survive unless we have a little survive unless we get a little bit crazy. No, we'll never survive unless we get a little bit. A world full of people, only someone to fly. Isn't that crazy? In a sky full of people, only someone to fly. Isn't that crazy? In a heaven of people, there's only someone to fly. Isn't that crazy? In a heaven of people, there's only someone to fly. Isn't that crazy?
Daniel, what are you doing? You're padding about in what I could only describe as an ominous fashion.
No, I'm just going to try this for size. That's a leg.
Ah, the Ina Sharples look.
Yeah, just
I've always wanted to be on Coronation Street.
Yeah, you just say yes to the camera.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, this is for the size.
Yes. She's giving me instructions now. She thinks she's a f***ing director. They'll cut that bit too.
No, wow.
Ah, your bondage kit. Daniel, what are you doing? Was this something you borrowed from that lady in New York?
Life isn't easy.
Oui. Ça va, comment tu? Oui. Ah, d'accord. Écoute, je sais pas appeler, mais ça serait impossible, le vin. Mais je
te... I like this shop already.
Écoute, est-ce que tu vas être chez toi demain?
This is a particular look I've always wanted to adopt. I hope he keeps it like this and doesn't do anything more. It just looks so perfect now. I could see myself in shorts, waltzing down the King's Road looking like this. Get a move on, Daniel. Stop talking foreign languages into the telephone.
It's a talent.
Ow! Will you stop poking that thing into my scalp?
So tell me...
The man's a sadist.
So tell me about
Excuse me, Daniel, can you just answer me one question? Yeah. What nationality was the Marquis de Sade?
I think he was a Frenchman.
Yes. Got it, viewer?
Yeah.
Ow! Daniel, why are you smearing chocolate mousse on my head?
Did you know what I was doing in my first life? I was a pâtissier.
The more things I get... When I bought a plastic bag last, they said, do not ever put a plastic bag over your head, they said. And you've just done it.
You got one now.
This is just too dreadful.
Of satellite television and international modelling, Eurolove can shine through. And as their eyes met across a Sony BVP 7 beta camcorder, hunky TV director Greg and Lithuanian supermodel Loretta knew that it was more than just a straightforward interview.
I was covering a fashion festival in Latvia, and being like a typical cheeky English boy abroad, we were chatting to all the girls, blah 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 blah, and I saw Loretta at a party that was held. And actually, I caught sight of her bottom first, and I thought, I must talk to that girl. And the next day, I got her to say something to me for camera. And then we started talking, and then that was about it, really.
And next today, Greg and I, blah, blah, blah.
what's this blah, blah, blah translated?
It's a kind of it's an intimate thing between two adults. But I think that the first blah, blah, blah we had was actually just a vocal blah, blah, blah. And then as things developed, we had a more physical blah, blah, blah. I said goodbye to Loretta on the Monday of 1 week. And 4 days later, I get a call from a satellite phone from Lithuania, which is, she doesn't have a phone in her house. So they have to go to stations. And it's like, hello, Greg, it's Loretta. I have 3 minutes to tell you everything. And then I'm getting my own voice coming back. It's like, I have ticket for London. What do you think? And I'm saying, Yeah, it sounds good, come over.
And you're living together?
Yeah, we're kind of cohabiting now, and we're able to blah, blah, blah now a lot more.
Now signed up to a top model agency, Loretta spent her first few weeks in Britain getting used to a new way of life, and more importantly, Greg's mother.
She's had a really good time in London. It's quite bizarre, the things we take for granted, things like custard, and that Loretta's never had before, and all these different things that we take for granted. Language, you have to explain words that you never really thought of before. You know, things like, how do you explain what custard tastes like? I challenge anybody.
Well, first time I have very much problem for language because I cannot speak English, and my first teacher is Greg, and only speak English for 2 weeks only.
This is quite funny. My mother, a typical East End lady, I phoned her up, I said, yo, mum, Loretta's coming round, she doesn't speak a lot of English, so you have to speak very, very carefully. And my mother, bless her, just thought this meant speak very loudly. So Loretta would come in the front door and my mother would have her face going, would you like a cup of tea? And I said, no, you haven't got to speak loudly, you have to speak slowly. So she thought slowly as like break down every syllable. So it's like, would you like a cup? Accelerator,
and I'm not
going.
In the selfish soul, Mother Greg.
So she's going, yes, yes. And I can always tell when she doesn't understand, she just nods and smiles like we all do.
All the time I say, yes, yes, I'm not understanding, yes.
And she goes, Greg, what is it?
But love is a two-way thing, and Greg, our ever-resourceful hero, has decided to learn Lithuanian, an uphill struggle for your actual average Cockney.
Say
it
quickly.
And that's about as far as I get.
And what does that mean?
You translate.
It means something like ten, a pig and ten little pigs or something.
Yes. No pig. This is chicken.
Chicken, that's it.
Six big chicken with little chickens.
That's one of the more handy.
Yes, because this is Lithuania.
Just imagine like your car's broken down, or you know, you've run out of money. You've got to try and get your way home. You go up to the police and say, "Excuse me, six big chickens and six little chickens."
And as we leave our courting couple to blah 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 in peace, we let them have the final word on the apparent friendliness towards Loretta of the entire male population of London.
When you go in London, because London is very warm, very big city, and said, because they go with shots, and said, oh, okay, you very wonderful, good morning. And this is good morning, no, inside, this is good morning. This is very good morning. They said, oh, good morning.
I know what you mean. It's more like a pickup thing to say.
Yeah, it's quite funny that she said very to me, she said, I came out of the house this morning. And these two boys came past. Said, oh, there's an attractive lady. Good morning, good morning. And she said to me, does that happen a lot? I said, yeah, if you wear them shorts, it probably does.
Do you sort of smell burning? Do you sort of see smoke emerging? There is smoke emerging, isn't there? Are you disturbed by this smoke emerging?
Let's have a look again.
Sort of dabbing at it. His heart's not in it, is it? It's like somebody looking at some sediment from the bottom of the River Thames.
Right, if you'd like to take over there, I think it's not green, but it'd be sort of an orangey colour. So
I hope to God, the one thing I've never wanted is a reputation as a good sport. Well, I wonder if it's worked. Do you find yourself fancying me, gentle viewer? Do you find an incredible lust creeping all over you because of what I now look like? Do you find your nipples hardening? Do you notice a bulge occurring in your trousers just because my hair looks better than it looked before? Or do you find me as repulsive as you always did? Oh, my God.
I must say,
never have I seen anything like it. It's a transformation, Daniel.
Yeah.
For God's sake, I look like Clint Eastwood.
Well, you are.
And you look a bit like Clyde.
Big, big, big.
Top model Rachel Hunter has it. The clean, fresh, natural look of today. The CoverGirl look. Now, CoverGirl Cosmetics introduces new, remarkable lipstick. A distinctly new kind of colour, so rich you can feel it. The result of a micro-concentrate formula for the richer look of more colour to the colour. Experience colours so rich you can feel it. New remarkable lipstick. Clean, fresh, natural. That's the look of CoverGirl.
Every day, thousands of sailors just receive a cheque from Legal & General. A ray of sunshine from the big company with the umbrella.
Nó bên ngoài bằng thế lên.
Mày hôn cảm sẵn tốn.
Dì hông dâng lên. Khói đôi đây nè.
Sunthorn just asked me what it was like back home. So I told him. It's exactly the same as it is here.
Draft bitter to take away. New from Guinness.
Oh, I see her face everywhere I go. On the street and even at the picture show. Have you seen her? Tell me, have you seen her? Oh, I hear her voice as the cold winds blow in the sweet music on the radio. Have you seen her? Tell me, have you seen her?
This Sunday in the News of the World, could your star signs release the hidden passion in your relationship? Mystic Meg's Astrosexy Part 1. And get your new Super Bingo card free and play for thousands every Sunday and every day in the sun, all in the News of the World this Sunday.
Come and browse at leisure in a store where it's a pleasure to relax and plan your home.
Courts you can.
We can answer questions, give advice and make suggestions. You can always call upon us.
Courts you can.
You can find much more to see of the highest quality
at prices that are sure to suit all sorts. The value's guaranteed for everything you need. So come again for courts you can at home.
Can I do that?
Of course you can.
Easy peaky.
Peasy, the rooftop quiz that goes on for 5 minutes, which is a lot longer than that, really.
And hello, Stelios.
Hello, Nino.
How are you today?
I'm very well today. How are you?
Yeah, I'm okay. It's very cold, isn't it, tonight?
It is cold.